Hello friends, now we will continue the same process UE is switch on. So actually in last tutorials have discussed over the how UE synchronize, how UE sync up with the DC subcarrier. After that how DC subcarrier have what is the use of the DC subcarrier, because of that it's identify the frequency, it's identify the frequency. Through the DC subcarrier, that mobile device used to help to find the LTE frequency band. In last video tutorial have checked. Now we will know that after synchronized with the DC subcarrier, now UE will start to read the primary and secondary synchronization. So both the FDD and TDD, there is actually you have seen this picture now. Yeah, both the FDD and TDD, this is the FDD, and synchronization signals in the downlink directions. For both FDD and TDD, LTE broadcast the synchronization signal in downlink direction, and this synchronization signal is a primary synchronization signal and secondary synchronization signal. So synchronization signal is broadcast within every 10 millisecond radio frame, and the UE use the synchronization signal to TDD. For the TDD, it will be used to achieve the radio frame, subframe, slot and sample synchronization in time domain, and in FDD it will be used to identify the center of channel bandwidth in frequency domain, and use the synchronization to reduce the physical layer cell identity. So now we'll see the in the primary synchronization signals. Primary synchronization signals is broadcast twice during the radio frame, and both transmission are identical. Twice. That means this total 20 slot is there, and 10 millisecond radio frame is there. It is first slot. First slot contain the total 6 symbol is there. Total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 symbol is there. Oh, sorry, 7 symbol is there. It's just a normal cyclic. So it is 7 symbol is there, and last symbol is used for the PSS, and 0 and 10 slot will be used here, 0 and 10. So the primary synchronization signal is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the last symbol of time slot 0 and 10. So PSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier, central 62 subcarrier. So you will, when you will see the central, this is a central 62 subcarrier, you can see here, this is the central. Central PSS above part of the DC subcarrier, and lower part of the DC subcarrier. You can see here you can see the DC. The DC above part first is the PSS. So same things here telling that ki PSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the last symbol of time slot 0 and 10. Last time slot of 0 and 10. So 0 and 10, last symbol. Last symbol is seen here. Last symbol is where is that? Yeah, last symbol is 6. Last symbol of 0 and 10 is 10. Is where is 10? This one is 10. 10 time slot 0 and 10 is broadcast of central subcarrier, where PSS is broadcast of the 0 and 10 time slot of last symbol PSS. And subframe 1 is always a special subframe. Sorry, it is for the TDD. And in case of TDD, what happens? In PSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarriers belonging to the third symbol of time slot. Then you will see here, it is for the TDD, right? So it is TDD. So TDD is telling that PSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the third symbol of time slot 2. Third symbol of the time slot 2. Third symbol using time slot, and third symbol of time slot 12. Slot 2. This is slot 2. The G12. time slot to third sample. Third sample 0, 1, 2 is third sample, and here 2, this is for the 2. So 2, 0, 1, 2 is used for the PSS, and the third sample of time slot 12, 12 is this one, 12 is, so here third is this one. So PSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the third sample of time slot 2 and the third sample of time slot 12. So 2 and 12 time slot and their third sample will be used for the PSS. And subframe 1 is always a special subframe. So the PSS is sent as part of the downlink pilot times DWPTS, sent as a part of DWPTS 1. So subframe 6, you can see here, subframe 6 is this one, may or may not be a special subframe. Depending upon the uplink downlink subframe configuration, it is a special subframe for configuration 0, 1, 2, and 6. Otherwise, it is a normal downlink subframe. PSS is used to achieve the subframe slot and sample synchronization in time domain. So, what is the use of PSS? Use of PSS to achieve the subframe slot and sample synchronization in time domain. Identify the center of channel bandwidth in frequency domain. In frequency domain, it will identify the channel bandwidth, identify the center of the channel bandwidth, and in time domain it will achieve the subframe slot and sample synchronization, and deduce the pointer toward the one of the physical layer cell identity. The PSS will use to identify, to deduce the physical cell identity PCI, and PCI are assigned or organized into 168 group of 3. So the primary synchronization signal identify the position of the PCI within the group but does not identify the group itself. So PSS can't be used to achieve the radio frame synchronization, because both transmission within the radio frame as identical as equal space and time. So this is a PSS. Now SSS secondary synchronization signal is broadcast. Secondary synchronization, you can see here, second last sample is used for the secondary synchronization. Last sample is the PSS, and second last one is SSS. You can see there, in just I want to show you in this one. Yeah, PSS is center frequency. Suppose that this is a finger frequency and there is a DC. So above this one PSS, and second last one is SSS. Secondary synchronization signal is broadcast twice within the every radio frame, and this one 5 and 5 radio frame. The two transmission of SSS are different, so the UE can detect which is the first and which is the second. In case of FDD, secondary synchronization signal is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the second to the last sample of time slot 0 and 10. It will use the 0 and 10 time slot, and second last sample will be used. There is a 7 sample for the 0 and 10 time slot. Second last sample is for the SSS. So in case of TDD, what happened? In TDD, the SSS is broadcast using the central 62 subcarrier belonging to the last sample of time slot 1 and the last sample of time slot 11. Last sample of the time slot 1 is 1, and last sample of time slot 11, this one is 11. So SSS is here, it's last sample. 6 is the last sample, 6 is the last sample. So one time slot contain, this one is the one. So you can see here, this one is 1, this one is 1, and this part 0 to 6 is the part of 1, and 2, 0 to this 6 part is part of 2. So you can see the color of 1 is low fed. So 0 to 6 is for the one, and this 0 to 6 part is for the this two. So large sample of time slot 1 is SSS. Here you also can see this is part of SSS. So both time slot 1 and 11 are always within the normal downlink subframe. SSS is used. What is the use of secondary synchronization signal? Secondary synchronization signal is used to achieve the radio frame synchronization. Radio frame synchronization, and it's allow the PCI to be deduced when combined with pointer from PSSS. So PSSS, and the primary and secondary synchronization signal in both the time and frequency domain for the FDD 3 MHz channel bandwidth. This actually it is different, and deduce the pointer toward the one of 168 physical cell identity. You know that PSS, what is the use of PSS? PSS is the one of three physical cell identity. Deduce the pointer toward the one of three physical layer cell identity, one of three PCI. And PCI are organized into in a group, 168 group of three. Okay? And SSS is used pointed toward the one of 168 physical layer cell identity group. So it SSS is used to identify the group, 168 group, and PSS is used to identify the physical cell identity, three physical cell identity. So and so this is PSS and SSS. This five above five and low five is used for the DTX. Five resource element above and below the synchronization signal are not used for the transmission. They represent the period of discontinuous transmission. These are present for FDD and TDD. So, and this set of the resource element allocated to the synchronization signal is introduced of the channel bandwidth. You does not require any knowledge of channel bandwidth prior to detecting the synchronization signal. The downlink channel bandwidth is subsequent read from the master information block and